What's good, YouTube family? This your God Bless One. Thank you for watching another episode of I Smoke Hip Hop. Hey, DC, we need to talk, man. And some of the New York areas, too. Well, I ain't going to throw New York in this, because I think New York would have done exactly what I expected them to do to that boy, Alpo. So, Alpo comes home, and I don't want to do this video, because I was like, man, I'm an old head. And my co-host BG did a crazy video. Salute to that nigga. I didn't want to talk about it because I was ashamed of the whole thing with Alpo and what he did and how he got sentenced. And I was ashamed of that. And I ain't even from New York like that. Lived over there, but I'm not from there like that. He just let me down. And you're seeing what's going on. If you guys don't know, check out this video here, what Big Meech had to say about Alpo. Meech, I was ashamed too, Meech. Not only you, Meech. I gotta sit here and look at this. Like, these niggas celebrated that nigga Alpo coming home. That nigga made a lot of real niggas go down with him. I don't think you people know that. Wayne, shout out to Wayne Perry. Wayne Perry protected this nigga nonstop. That was the force that Alpo needed to become great. It was Wayne Perry. That nigga rotting away right now, but this nigga Alpo getting celebrations. That's what we do to snitch, DC. And this ain't towards DC as a whole. Let me make that public announcement. DC, salute to y'all. Y'all always been real. Y'all the land of the dreadheads like my state of Florida. Salute to y'all. This is to them corny niggas. Yes, corny niggas. Say, I'm not afraid like you niggas to say shit like that. I don't care if this video go viral or if only 200 people see this video. It gotta be said, man, where I'm from, I'm cut from a different cloth. I ain't no gangster. I ain't no banger. I'm just a regular nigga who grew up in the hood, who understood there was rules and regulations to this shit. So when I see you niggas throwing celebrations for this, no wonder you got these wild young niggas behaving crazy out here and ain't no fucking loyalty to the court. Ain't no niggas standing solid no more. You niggas can't stand on your 10 toes no more and stay on your pivot. You being knocked on your pivot by minor charges and you just throw your whole man's life away. He can't go home to his family because you was taken away from yours? So this is an eye for eye when we're homeboys and one of us get roped up? Or is it supposed to be, nigga, just don't talk, whatever happens, happens, but you be loyal to that shit and you stand on it. You niggas did a celebration for this nigga. All these niggas getting celebration. I wouldn't be surprised if on the cake they said thank you for snitching. Like, I mean, might as well, right? Ain't like my kids know the story of Alpo. Are they even supposed to know that story? They know the story. My daughter, though. The oldest kid I got is only, what, 6 years old? I got all babies, man. Well, hopefully the oldest is only six. But anyway, you got a lot of kids. You got a lot of kids. What black nigga you know that don't got a lot of kids? Fuck out of here. It's not if you got a lot of kids. It's can you take care of your kids? I was laughing at some other shit on the Murray Show. But anyways, but yeah, man, you niggas celebrated for this nigga. Faces, everything being shown. I felt Big Meech. You got real niggas doing football numbers because they want to stand 10 toes down. These niggas could have been home in like 2-3 years and still get to live off the foundation of the drug monies they had or whatever and shit like that. They would have been solid right now, but they have an honor code and an honor system. Some of them could have talked without even doing 1 hour in that bitch. Not even 1 hour, but they were solid, my nigga. You got a lot of solid people who took years. I don't even listen to my song like that. But salute to that nigga. Salute to Mano. Salute to all these niggas you know that did all these big time numbers off the street. Hey, no offense to these dudes. I'm going to talk about some of my boys. Free that boy's OP. Free all my niggas that's from my town that's locked up. Because we do a lot of times saying free this celebrity. Free this nigga. But what about our niggas? What about the niggas we played in the jungle gyms with? What about the niggas we was cool with before we was fucking hoes when we was just flirting with girls writing on letters? Do you go with me? Then your boy got to pass the bitch around. You probably, excuse my language. And yes, ladies, I was 7 years old, so don't say that Hassan Campbell shit to me. But that's what I'm trying to tell you guys. Like, you don't even say free the nigga that you grew up with, but you expect hood niggas to be loyal to each other now? I seen everybody and their mama say free Meek Mill, but you niggas got brothers doing 20, 30. You got best friends doing 10. You got the mamas home. You ain't even giving the nigga a dollar, but you go, oh, I'm going to support you, Meek Mill. Some of you bought like 3 or 4 albums. You got a nigga sitting. You couldn't even hit that J-Pay to pay this nigga $30, $20, $10. My nigga, $5 will put a smile on a nigga face. I ain't never did no serious time. Have I been locked up before? Yes. But once again, with my stereotype, what black nigga you know haven't been locked up before? I got no record of that or nothing. But yes, you can pull up my information because you niggas like, I expose you. I expose you. I got locked up for a robbery situation. I told y'all the story already. Went to the movies. And this involves snitching as well, too. I was supposed to be at the movies. My twin and my homeboy didn't go with me, so I was solo doing a dolo. And I seen, like, a couple of niggas was coming my way. Niggas I got beef with or whatever. I was supposed to meet my date. She ain't never came. So I'm looking like, is it a setup? And when them niggas was coming, remember, I'm dolo. So a group of niggas that were older than us that I knew, every time I skipped school, I would hang with the older crowd. And I knew a lot of them other cats over there. I seen them. I kind of just walked their way. I ain't asked for help or nothing. I kind of wanted the other niggas to see, like, you know, like, this nigga, he got full of niggas with him. We're going to leave him alone. And shit turned left. These niggas rob a fucking car right in the middle of us dapping it up, saying what's good. They pull a purse out of the fucking vehicle. And you got all these undercover officers swarming everywhere. And I didn't care about all that. Like, I've been arrested before by lame-ass officers. And I know if you didn't do nothing, don't sweat. Like, niggas, stay solid, right? Even if you did do something, stay. Like, you know that from your people. Like, stay solid. But I didn't care about all that. I just worried about, damn, my parents gonna get mad at me. But the niggas who got locked up with me, y'all, the older niggas who I thought was solid, who I was skipping school thinking is official, they end up snitching on me. Real shit. Thank God that shit was dismissed. I only did, like, what, 5 days or some shit like that? Only, like, 5 days, which is, like, that's why I say it's nothing. But them 5 days, sure enough, told me I don't want to do a day in that bitch with some fraud shit like that. You showing love. Because I could have easily said I wasn't there. They took it off. But I didn't say none of that. I didn't even mention I didn't know what was going on. I just shut the fuck up and say, hey, because we got it on camera. If you got it on camera, then you would see me walking over. That's why I didn't panic. But these niggas did. And I feel like everybody at that celebration was some snitch-ass niggas celebrating Alpo's home return. I believe everybody you seen that was involved in that celebration, they got a lot of niggas' football numbers. Salute to New York, because I think if Alpo go to New York, we ain't seen that nigga again. Y'all should have violated Alpo. I'm not afraid to say that. Now I'm about to turn up on the video. My nigga, you deserve 21-gun salute with 12-gauge being blown to the back of your, you know what, bro, your cranium. Let me watch my words. You deserve that, bro. You deserve shells to the face, to the point your face is disfigured where your mama can't recognize you. To your mama, you her baby boy. To us, you the baby snitch. Big snitch, actually. Look how much niggas you took down. Big snitch. Yeah, you get to do celebration. Man, fuck an Alpo. That's real shit. Oh, I see you left Alpo Jr. out here running somewhere. I see his face sliced up and all that. Nigga, you didn't even take care of your C's out here, my nigga. You went out like a sucker for real, bro. I'm not going to even judge you about rich death or whatever. You feel what I'm saying? I believe it was sucker shit you did, but is it enough that you should be, you know, done away because of that? I don't know. If I was in that type of life and a nigga was lying about the numbers to me, playing me, he supposed to be my boys, I might feel like how you felt. You feel what I'm saying? So I'm not coming at you for that. I'm only coming for the snitching part, my nigga. That's it. That's the only thing people should be. I don't want to hear about what he did to Rich and this and that. Nigga, that's part of the game, man. But what part of the game is snitching to the niggas you was loyal to or the niggas that was loyal to you? Niggas that took penitentiary lifetime sentences and away from their families to be loyal to your whole ass, bro. The whole cloth, the whole myth about Alpo don't do anything to me other than I smell a fucking rat. That's what I do. Salute to the Italian mobs and mafia. Salute to them. Because even if you're in that jailhouse, you're going to get touched up. Look at, I know it ain't the Italian mafia, but it's still the mob to what happened to Wiley Boger. I probably butchered his name, but look what happened to his. And he got his. How the hell Alpo was never touched? And yes, you can be touched in protective custody. Yes, you can be touching protective custody. That is not false at all. Don't believe in all that bullshit. But man, I was sick too, Big Meech. It wasn't only you, fam. These niggas done did a whole celebration for Alpo. Damn. I'm your God bless one, man. Love your family. Love your kids. And stay blessed, everybody.